Hi, we're off on another Skye trip today. Car's all packed up, just about just going to make the sandwiches. Back the car last night, actually. I'll tell you, it's for a walk. I'm just going to get some porridge for breakfast, make the sandwiches, and set up a big upgrade cooper. I'm just going to truck loads of stuff and try to fit in it. Right, we're at Bretton Services now. Basically took up the entire boot, left me with one little seat in the back. Got all the stuff in. I mean, it's like cooler box disaster, it wasn't working. But I used all the technical skills and I cleaned the fuse and it's working now, so that's pretty good as well. So we're just enjoying a drink and then we're gonna get going. Yes, Guinness, we'll get one of those with Ray later, I think it's my time to buy as well, actually, because he bought them last time. Right, so we'll finish our drinks. Oh, sorry, what was that, Graham? No. We'll get our brews and we'll get going. Next stop in Inverurbas, I suspect. Here we are at Ellendonan. We've had a wee. Time to crack on soon, I think, and get to Skye. Get the tent up before the rain and the winds come. And get some
food in my tummy.
So back at Glenbrittle, and there's the tents up again. The 31-year-olds, the 31, yeah, Peapod. That's up, and there's the 56-year-old or whatever you are, Graham. He's up. He's having a snack before his tea. That's the way to do it. This is living. And there's our stores ready to have some tea. I might have beans and sausage, or I might have a curry. I'll see how much toilet roll I've got. This is how busy the campsite is. This is how busy the campsite is. Plenty of nutters kicking about, daft as us do. Right, we've had our tea now, chilli and rice, the pair of us. Both of us, the pair of us, whatever. Graham's in there now doing something, I don't know what he's doing in his tent. He's making a lot of noise. All right, Graham. Good. He's doing a lot of blowing noises.
This is the best Friday night I've ever had. I'm sat in a car with Graham Cooper. It's about minus 14 outside, pouring with rain, gale force winds, and I'm being forced to drink cider. I feel like a 16-year-old schoolgirl. I just can't catch one. Are you having a good time, Graham? That's his nickname for his snake. Right, thanks everybody.
Just put my beans in that.
Graham's got fresh sausages. Well, salmonella sausages. They've been festering away in the car. Okay. I'm going to have a can, healthy stuff. Well, I've had a nice night's sleep. It's a bit chilly now though. But I've had my morning poop, which is very important to me. What was rather disturbing was when I went in, there was a load of flies. When I came out, they'd gone. Gone where? I'm not too sure. Lenny McCoop's making me coffee for me. That water is from the Ice Age. I don't mean it's from the Ice Age, I mean you started boiling it in the Ice Age. Right, we've had our breakfasts now. So we're gonna get packed up, drive to the ferry pool. It's about 3 or 4 miles away so far. And see if we can mingle with all the other tourists. There'll be about 27,000 there now. It's about 8 o'clock in the morning at the minute. There's the aftermath of breakfast. Graham's mess. I've not left any mess whatsoever. There's the ferry pools. There's all the tourists, if you like that sort of thing.
Right, we've been camping last night and we've come to the ferry pools today. Tricky stepping stones, which I don't like. And also, let me just count them, there's 827,413 people, tourists, loads of them. Keep away. Why can't you just go somewhere else? Let us regulars take over. There's too many tourists. Too many. Thank you.
We've come to Dunvegan now, too many tourists at the fairy pools, and we don't like people. A bit breezy. Right, we're at Dunvegan now. It's a bit breezy. I've had ravioli. Graham's made homemade soup, I think, or something like that. Wooden spoon and a chopping board. At least we went over the stepping stones. That would go up very quick in case I slipped, tripped or fell. How's your soup? Alright. Very good. Right, we're making our tea now. I'll be honest with you, it could have been a little bit warmer. Not your tea. Be better. How's your tea, Graham? How much have you got?
Loads.
Now I'm having potatoes, mince, and sweet corn, and I'm busting for a wee. Again. I think I might have eaten too much.
Right, it's about 7:30 on Sunday now, and I don't want to lie to you, it's not the best night's sleep I've ever had. Gale force winds waking me up all the time, and then some seagulls fighting for a can of, well, an empty can that was left in the bin bag, burst that open, woke me up. So I'm up now, make a brew. But that doesn't look very clever. We're going to walk along the Kurang today, we'll see. Looks like it's going to pull down at any minute. So yeah, weather's not so good. We'll see how we get on. We're surviving. Survival mode's on.
Right, we're on the Kurang now. Graham's had to stop again for more food and water. I'm fine, I'm like a camel. I can go forever. Took a few photographs. That's about it, really. So we'll crack on shortly. So we're at the Kurang now, the famous Kurang tree. I think everybody's photographed that. People who haven't even got a camera have photographed that. It's not so bad, is it? Not so bad. This is such a fabulous landscape. Graham?
Yeah.
Is this such a fabulous landscape?
No.
Very good.
Breathtaking,
yeah. Where's the toilets?
There.
Right.
This is a beautiful spot.
Right, we've come to Portree now, maybe try and get a drink of coffee or something, and there's absolutely not a single tourist here at all. Not a one. Right, we're having a coffee now in the centre of Portree. Looks like all the tourists have gone now for some reason, I don't know. We've been attacked by seagulls. Not a very nice thing, is it? Seagulls eating your chips. Thank you.
Hello.
Hello.
Right, we're at the Sligerhood now. I'm drinking Guinness. I'm trying to get Wi-Fi to contact Ray Campbell, but can't.
So, that's
it, really.
How are
we? Pint and Guinness and drive even more dangerously on Sky Roads.
We're having a few problems with the Golden Showers. Golden Showers app. Oh, sorry, Golden Hour app. It used to have a slider to tell you where the sun was going to be at a certain time. And now it just says there's a sun. It shows you where it is, but you don't need it. All you've got to do is look up. You can see it in the sky. So yeah, we're not securing this Golden Showers app now. We're going to replace it with something else, I think. Right, Graham's had a shower. He smells like roses. I've not. I smell like something not pleasant. So I might go and get one now.
The fertiliser you put around roses.
Yes, I smell like the fertiliser you put around roses. So I might go and video myself in the shower if you'd like to see that, boys and girls. Sorry? Alright. I won't then. I'll just go and get a shower and clean my teeth. I've had the same undercrackers on for 3 days. Probably need a bit of a change now. They're a bit, moist.
We both had showers. Well, we had our tea, chicken tikka and chicken jalfrezi and a bit of rice, eating that outside. Graham had a shower earlier on, I've had one now. I smell like roses. I've had a poop, which is good. So now it's time for another film on the old iPad. Not sure what we're watching this time, and I don't know, 16 or 17 cans of cider. Apparently that's good for my blood sugar.
Right, I'm at the Commando Memorial now, on our way home. Don't really want to go home. Well, I want to go and see Julie and Frank, but I'd rather be in Scotland than going back to work, I'm afraid. There you go. Right, we're at Inverurglass now for a lunch stop. Just had a light lunch. Just had a chicken and mayo lettuce sandwich, some Snacker Jacks, pack of the nuts, can of Red Bull, coffee, apple juice, some crisps, a Mars bar, a Twix, and a yoghurt. That should keep me going for the next couple of hours, I suppose. See how we get on. Stimmy diabetes good anyhow. It's giving a bit of a shock.
Are you having a light lunch, Graham?
Yeah.
Water?
Water. Orange.
Is it?
Make it boring.